All that and so much more, Sports Xtra starts
right now.
They call it America's favorite pastime, and it's back in session. That's right, baseball is back, and we'd be lying if we told you that we aren't excited. So, what's the only thing better than watching the UNC baseball team play? Watching two UNC baseball teams play. It wouldn't be March Madness without everyone making a bracket and having some of those brackets go up in flames almost immediately. Hatchell and her entire staff are on paid administrative leave. An outside firm is investigating allegations that Hatchell made a series of racially charged remarks and forced players to play through serious injuries. According to the Washington Post, Hatchell told players they would be hanged from trees with nooses if their on-court performance didn't improve. After a five-hour rain delay, UNC's opening baseball game against the University of South Florida took a while to click into gear on Saturday night. But let me tell you, it was well worth the wait. We hinted at it earlier, but even if we didn't say anything,
there's a basketball game this Wednesday. No biggie.
Carolina's women's basketball team finished up the regular season with a trip to Duke on Sunday afternoon. And unfortunately for the Heels, it didn't end well. The Carolina women's basketball team is on a roll. Three quality wins in a row, including an upset against top-ranked Notre Dame 1 week ago. To keep that streak alive, the Heels would need to beat undefeated and seventh-ranked NC State in Raleigh on Sunday afternoon. Virginia owns the tiebreaker against UNC, Duke owns the tiebreaker against Virginia, and UNC currently holds the tiebreaker against Duke. But that could all change if Duke beats UNC in Chapel Hill on March 9th. Stallings Medical Center is one of the many places here on campus that athletes from UNC's 26 varsity teams visit for treatment. Other medical centers are located on South Campus for specific sports such as football, baseball, and of course, basketball.
Way to go, Cam.
Well, let's get back to the real athletes. One thing that sets them apart from Cam and other wannabes, hours and hours in the weight room. Devonte Anthony introduces us to Carolina's new strength and conditioning coach. It's no secret that the Tar Heels are one of the best teams in the country, but now we have an even better way to prove it. I investigated the new net ranking system for the NCAA tournament and how it helps the Heels in March.